Take here the case of Akshay Kumar. He is always on a learning curve, but what is the difference? Okay. As I said, it's a transition. He has gone through, Akshay Kumar is known as, he was born as Rajiv Bhatia.
Yes.
An Indian actor known for his different kind of films. Okay. Films, he's done so many films and he's so much focused, so dedicated. He doesn't believe in making enemies. He's friendly with everybody, but yet he maintains his own privacy. So you will be able to see a lot of this nakshatra's traits coming in, especially because the nakshatra lord, the lord of the lagna and the lagna both fall in this nakshatra for him.
Very strong.
So this nakshatra will have a very strong resonance in his life. He's earned plenty, but he's also given plenty to the society. One of the few actors who has supported Paralympics. He has been very vocal about sports, and he has supported people on a number of levels in this case. He has won the national, the Dada Saab Phalke Award, I believe, the national awards also. Filmfare Award is something that he has been given, but on a national level of also, he's been awarded for his movies. He's taken up social causes, okay, in his movies, and he's worked on them, and he's also made money. But nevertheless, the genre that people didn't want to move into, he's very boldly gone there, and he's done his job on that.
Yes, and that boldness is even reinstantiated because Jupiter is in trines, and both our friends are helping each other.
Yes, and they're helping each other. And Jupiter happens to be his second and fifth lord. Second lord of his wealth, and fifth lord of luck.
Yes.
So Jupiter has helped him, and Mars again is, as we know, Mars is a warrior. He is a martial arts specialist. He's known to be a fitness freak.
Yes. Yes.
And one more point that I would like to add here is, in one of his interviews, he said that he never ever sleeps when the sun is rising. If he's late from his shoot, he waits for the sun to rise. If he's early, he sleeps early, he gets up early, but he has to see the sunrise.
Okay.
And Mitra is one of the forms of sun. Okay. So life has a very funny way of expressing itself. You see it happening in his chart, because maybe he was told, or maybe he said he's been doing it for years altogether. So he did it unknowingly, but that has also helped in his phenomenal rise.
And sun is also very, very, very strong here. It's in directional strength and in own sign.
Yes. So, yes, and it's in his... It's such a beautifully placed because as I see it, yes, okay. As I see it, it's also instated with the nakshatra lord.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so it's very beautifully placed, sun also. So these charts do make him a very strong personality. These placements do make him a very strong personality.
And I had heard once that he got some award, but he gave it to somebody else. I don't know if that was true or something. I've heard it once. So that Anuradha nature can also come in that, appreciating others.
Yes, appreciate. The amount of hard work that he puts in for, the needy in terms of Paralympics or the people who are actually love sports but do not have the ability to carry the financial needs, the financial ability to go ahead with them. He does help. He does a lot of voluntary work. He does a lot of social work. He does a lot of financial helping on a number of levels. And that comes from Anuradha. Not to mention that he has a very keen and a very focused sense of making money. And about that, he's not at all apologetic about it. Because he's also seen a lot of hard days.
The second lord is exalted, and that too in the ninth house.
Yes. So he loves it. He loves making money, but he loves helping others also.
Yes. And that this thing, K2 thing comes in that, this helping that Paralympiad, that thing.
Yeah.
Because K2 represents those handicap that.
It's also in his 12th house. 12th house is the house of spirituality.
Yes.
With the moon. So he has a mind frame of helping others.
Yes, it's very harmonious.
Yeah, and you know, these people also go through a tough time in life. Everybody, all of us go through, but these people have the ability to use it to their own betterment.
Yes.
As we saw about Sage Parashara, he was helped. As we saw about Gordon Ramsay, he came from a very cranky, as I said, from a very dysfunctional family. But nevertheless, he used it to move ahead in life, probably thinking that I do not want to be in the same state. I want to move ahead in life. And these people have a transformation. Now, they do not, as with your triumphant, gateways, where you move from one, you definitely choose a different background, okay? You come from a different background, you move to a different genre. Gordon Ramsay wanted to play football. He wanted to play football, if I'm not wrong, or baseball. I don't remember which game, but he wanted to play, I think, football for his state or his country. He was just 14 years, but he had a problem with his leg, and so he had to let go. And that is when he picked up the knife. We know about Akshay Kumar that he is a martial art specialist. He wanted to work in that. Sports was a very strong point for him, but he could not do that. And he has worked the streets and then reached where he has. So these people, they start off with one career in mind and they end up with another. So we move on to the final part. Okay, we move on to the final part here. And this final part is all about the planet and the remedial measures. I'll go through this final part very quickly. What is the planet here? The planet here is Saturn. The Saturn is strict. It has a lot of restrictions. And it is very restrictive. It provides you with a framework. So it has, you have to move into a very straight and narrow genre. I mean, you cannot move. Jupiter gives you a lot of affluence. It gives you an ability to move in a very any direction that you want, because planet, as far as Jupiter is concerned, it's all about ether. So ether is the vast space. It gives you the ability to move into a lot of directions. But this planet does not allow you that. It is very strict as a teacher. You do this work and you will be rewarded. You don't do it, you face the consequences. And it is also very traditional a planet. It is conventional. We have a lot of stories of Saturn, but I don't want to go there because we are running short of time. So probably in some other Saturn Nakshatra, we'll pick it up. So what are the professions associated with these people? It's the hypnotists, the psychic mediums, the occultists, the astrologers, spies. These people are the master of disguise.
Okay.
So they talk about one thing. It also depends on manipulation. As I told you, they can manipulate, they can be manipulated. You can take manipulation into two different levels. You can use that as saving your country, or you can use that bringing your country down again. So you can act as a spy for your country, or you can become, a bad name to your country, God forbid. People involved in
idolatry. One thing I've seen with these people, sometimes I've seen if the dasha is of a malefic, especially like Rahu, then they need to be careful. Then I have seen they're getting manipulated.
Because Rahu is essentially what? Rahu is essentially your thing. It is the chalava, or what do I call it? It's fraud.
Fraud cloud.
It's a cloud. It's basically a scheme that you see on the milk. It is it just goes away. It's a foam. It doesn't have much of an existence. Within minutes, it's all gone. So it shows you a different picture, and what you get at the end of the day is a different story altogether.
Yeah, and especially I've seen if this is also connected with marriage, like Venus or 7th house especially, or the 7th lord, then I have seen these people that, and if somehow this Rahu thing also comes, then I have seen their partners will say, oh yeah, we will marry you, but then they do not give a yes, nor do they give a no. So they're stuck in between.
Yeah, it does not materialize, but over a long run, it will not materialize because they are very affable. On the face, they will not show any problems.
Okay.
So, and as I said to you earlier, if by any chance it has a problem, then it will, if it is afflicted, then it definitely will show, that a different picture over ahead, and a different manipulation becomes a very key thing with these nakshatras. Again, depending on who's sitting there. If my Lagna Lord is sitting there, then I'm the one manipulating.
Seventh Lord, then the other one. Yes, correct, perfect.
So there are psychologists, explorers, these people, as I said, there's one deity associated with it, it's Saraswati. So learning, always learning and learning. And foreign travels, traveling becomes very important for these people also. Counselors, because these people, as I said, are friendly, and a friend needs to be able to understand your psyche. So they make excellent counselors. Industrialists, musicians, managers, artists. So these are some professions these people can follow. If you have your 10th lord specially situated here, go ahead and do that. You're likely to find success, but as I have said earlier, not once, not in one go, probably in the second time you will hit the board.